Hi everyone, I am Balu. In this video, I will explain about UGC NET November 2017 notification. After this video, you will get clear clarification about UGC NET results declaration and all changes made by UGC. In this notification, we have mainly three changes. One is first paper questions and second one is third paper pass percentage and third one is results declaration criteria. We'll see about it.
I am here to discuss about University Grants Commission National Eligibility Test November 2017 notification and all changes with positives and negatives. For eligibility for assistant professor only or junior research fellowship and eligibility for assistant professor both. In this video, I will discuss important things only. Important dates. Submission of online application 11-8-2017 and last date of online application 11-9-2017 and date of examination 5-November-2017. Examination fee also changed, but this is not a thing to discuss here. 1000 for general category, 500 for OBC, and 250 for SC/ST PWD. And test schedule. Here we have one main change. As of now, in first paper we have 60 questions and 10 questions are optional. But in this notification, we don't have optional questions. All are compulsory. In first paper we have 50 questions. All are compulsory. Okay, this is one minus point to these candidates. And second paper, third paper, as usual, second paper 50 questions and third paper 75 questions, all are compulsory, there is no change. And each question carry 2 marks, there is no negative marking, all questions are need to attempt. And then criteria for declaration of result. Step 1, there is no change. The candidates are required to obtain minimum marks in the aggregate of all three papers, that is paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3, which is, here we have another main change, that is, till now, for general, we need to obtain 40% for paper 1, paper 2 and 50% for paper 3. As usual, SC, ST, PWD and OBC, 35% marks for paper 1, paper 2 and 40% marks for paper 3. But in this notification, this is plus point to in this year candidates, we just need to obtain 40% aggregate marks in all three papers. That means all three papers marks calculated together. If it is more than 140 for general and more than 123 for SC/ST, PWD and OBC, then you will be declared as UGC qualified, but only if you are in that 6%. No need to worry about it. I will explain about the 6% clearly. Step 2 also, there is no change. Who have successfully completed step 1, then a merit list will be prepared subject wise and category wise. Step 3, here we have another main change. Please listen carefully. I will explain it clearly what is main change here. The number of slots for eligibility for assistant professor only will be equal to 6% of the candidates appeared in all three papers of NET, the subject-wise and category-wise. Distribution of slots will be calculated by using similar formula as used for calculation slots for JRF as mentioned on next page. This is the formula for calculation. This formula will be used for all categories and all subjects. Here we have an important thing. Here I'm discussing about difference. As of now, here I'm taking one example. If 1 lakh candidates are applied in general category, if in that 10,000 people are qualified by minimum criteria, so top 15 is taken from in this few qualified only, not from that 1 lakh. So 15% in 10,000 is 1500. So that's it. Then no more changes by UGC. These 1500 people are declared as UGC qualified. If we compare these 1500 to 1 lakh, it's just 1.5%. This is just not an example. If we consider last few years of UGC NET passing history, it's just 5 to 6%. That means 5 to 6 lakh candidates are applied for UGC NET. Just 30 to 35,000 candidates are declared as professors. And 1% candidates are, below 1% candidates are declared as JRF. This is very bad thing. This is also one reason to change this criteria to simple way. Yeah. Just remember this 1500. From now here I'm taking same example. If 1 lakh people are applied in general category, if in that 10,000 people are qualified by minimum criteria, so merit list is prepared here with all these 10,000 people. If these 10,000 is equal to 6% in 1 lakh, then okay. But 6% in 1 lakh equal to 6,000. So it's not equal. So top 6,000 people are taken from this 10,000 list. Then these 10,000 people are declared as UGC qualified. Just see this difference. It's just 1500 only. They should need to qualify 6%. This is main rule. And this is good news to in this year candidates. Now going to step 5. A separate merit list for the award of JRF will be prepared from the among the net qualified candidates figuring in the merit list prepared under the step 3 by using this formula mentioned on the next page. Yes, same formula will be used for that. That's it.
If you have any queries, please comment below. If you like my video, please click on thumb symbol and subscribe my channel. In my next video, I will show you how to fill UGC NET online application with demo. Take care. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.